Hola amigos, estoy aquí en el globo del Mago de Oz, de la película Oz, The Great and Powerful. Vamos a ver a qué aventura me podrá llevar esto. ¿Será que me encontraré a James Franco, o a Michelle Williams, o a Mila Kunis? Ahí veremos. Bye.
You have nice eyes.
Oh, thank you. Hi guys, I'm here with James Franco, who everyone knows him as a talented actor, director, writer, artist, professor, and now a magician.
I liked your introduction.
Oh, thank you.
Your enthusiasm.
Tell me, how did you prepare for this character?
Well, I've been a fan of the Oz books for a long time, so I kind of knew, I guess I had a feel for the world of Oz. Certain tones in Oz, but the character was written in a way that was comedic, so I sort of just fell in line with that. I did need to learn a few magic tricks, so I was trained by a magician named Lance Burton. But I guess more than anything, it was just working with the script and really figuring out how best to both make the character funny, but give him sort of an emotion, ground him in an emotional arc so that you know, an audience could follow his emotional journey.
So tell me a little bit about your character, please.
So I play Evanora, I'm the Wicked Witch of the East. I can fly, I can shoot lightning bolts out of my fingers, and I'm very, 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 very bad.
You're bad?
Very bad.
You play Finley, who's a monkey.
Yeah.
Did you only do the voice, or were you actually on set?
Like, I was on set there acting. Sam really wanted us to be there on set, interacting with each other, and improvising, and really having it. He wanted it to feel like two buddies on a journey together. He didn't want it to feel like, oh, someone went in a sound booth at the end of the movie.
At the beginning of the movie, you play a different character. Mm-hmm. How can you compare this first character with the Good Witch?
Maybe she is the Good Witch in a human form. That's kind of what we thought. You know, this is maybe, you know, maybe in Annie, that's the girl's name, maybe in her dreams she's like Glinda. You know, the question is, what is the real world? Is it the beginning? Is it the end?
How did you get involved in this project?
Well, my agent at CAA called me and said he had a screenplay he wanted me to read, and it was this script. But I didn't want to read it at the time because I had such love for the classic movie, The Wizard of Oz, that I didn't want to make a prequel to it because I thought it may not have respected the original or treaded upon its good name or traded upon its good name. So I just didn't read it. And it was only weeks later that to read a writing sample of a writer I was looking for, I read this script and fell in love with the character and the story.
How was a typical day when you went to set? Like, how long did it take to do between wardrobe and makeup and?
Mondays began at 4 a.m. and Fridays began at like noon. And you averaged about 16, 17 hour days. And you just ended up turning yourself around in the afternoons.
So it was crazy, crazy days for you, but I'm guessing it was a lot of fun, because it looked like fun.
It was 6 months. It was, you know, it was the longest production I've ever been on. And the most gratifying at the end of the day.
This is all I know how to say. Tell me if my accent's good. It's actually
pretty good.
That's pretty good, right?
Yeah. It's better than mine.
He's coming with it. There you go.
I was able to get
however just, you need. There you go. Grab a hold there. I'm here. If you need to grab my shoulder, whatever.
I'm just afraid to hit someone with the heel.
There we go. We'll watch. We'll get you out. There we go. There you go, honey.
Thank you.